Hello everyone, Killmedium here. Today I will introduce you guys a new gaming browser. It's a new browser from Opera, which is available since 2 days. And it's basically a browser which is optimized for gaming. You can set up your CPU, your RAM, everything with the GX control. We will do everything together. Let's install it really quick. Let's go options. Go when you are installing it, go into options and disable that. So basically it will stop sending information to Opera. You don't want that. So let's continue. Maybe by disabling that, it will maybe give you much more less CPU usage. Let's install it really quick. It's really fast. Oh, it even looks nice on the startup. We will do all the settings together. Basically, it's really important to watch the video, like to watch the entire video, because I will give some special settings. And I have some links which I will put in the description below. The download link and Adobe link. I forgot to install it in English, so I will have to change the language really quick so you guys can understand it better. Let me do that really quick and restart. Alright, we're gonna start off with this site. We're gonna go here and disable on the game sections these two things. After that, we go here on the GX control. Here we enable the RAM limiter and the CPU limiter. And you are basically just not touching it. Just leave it like this. And for me, I would leave it on the highest possible. If you get problems with this browser, if it's using way too much RAM, then you can limit it here to, depending how much RAM you have, you can put it on 4, 8 or, like, this is just for me, I have 16 gigs of RAM. So it's enough, I will just keep it at the highest possible. And here is the most important part, guys. Here it's important that the processor limit has to stay at 100%. If you are enabling it, then basically just leave it at 100, because let's see, if it's at 25%, what I understand here is when your browser reaches like 25% usage, then it will crash, then it will not go above and your FPS will go down. So make sure to put it at 100 so it will not get limited, like when you play Dark Orbit and your CPU usage is like above 25 or 50, then your FPS will not go down when it's at 100%. So make sure to leave it at 100%. Alright, that's it. The hard limit, just let it disabled. It's everything alright. Just use the settings here. And we go straight up to the settings. Make sure to enable block ads, surf the web up to 3 times faster. Disable wallpapers. It's here just the basic settings. We gonna start off with the basic settings, then we go down to the privacy features and browser settings. Alright, show bookmarks bar disabled, customize fonts, page zoom not needed, pressing tab on web page, this can be enabled, quick access, what was that? Not needed, we just go back to basics. Sidebar, we don't have to manage any sidebar. Also no sync, nothing. This browser, just keep it only for Dark Orbit, nothing else. Search engine can stay Google. I just use Google Chrome when I am for me this browser is only for Dark Orbit. No, we don't want this to be our default browser. On startup, I would like to use begin fresh, wait, open a specific site. I will just type Dark Orbit. But like when I start the browser, I would like to start it with Dark Orbit. Now we go privacy and security. I think, yeah, it's already advanced. That was basic. Let's go privacy and security. User prediction. This can be enabled, sent, disabled. Allow site to check. Enabled. Enabled. Manage cert. That's not for us. Automatically send crash. That can be disabled. You don't want a background program which is also running to send information to Opera. Help improve, disable, protect me from, you can enable it. Also enable, send news, disable. Let's go down together. Web, what is that? Use, no, this, just let it at recommended. Let it at. It even has a VPN, nice. But disabled, battery saver, oh my god guys. This is also limiting your FPS. If you want the stable, the most stable FPS, then make sure to disable it. Like, battery saver, no way, we don't need that. Instant search, you can, we don't really need that. Disable it. MyFlow, disable. Crypto wallet. Connect Opera with your phone to easily. No, disable. Search pop-up. This can be enabled. Video pop-out, enabled. Personal news. Let it disabled. Let me check. Rekey promoted. This is all the standard settings. I will just leave it like this. Show. Adjust automatically. This can be all standard. User interface, show tab pre. There is not really something. Wait, enable Chromecast. Yeah, disabled. Language is, you can choose your own language. If you are Turkish or German, you can just change it here. Downloads. Use hardware acceleration. Never disable that, please. Never. That always has to be enabled. Okay, here's one really important part. Opera has this one thing. If you, for example, press too many times the right click or left click, then something will appear. So make sure to you have to disable that. Configure shortcuts. Wait, yeah, here the keyboard shortcuts. It's important to disable, delete. Like if you are using my keyboard, when I was pressing like the diamond formation, which is F3, something like find next would come. I couldn't change my config the entire time. So make sure to disable everything, to delete everything here what you basically press. Like, let me see. Just and if you did a mistake, you can basically just come here and press on reset all. What else can we remove? Let me check. Focus next pane. Wait, this is not, I don't use this button for changing formations. I have my special keys for that. And help, we can also disable F1. Like this is only if you are using my keyboard settings. I will link this video if you are wondering what kind of keyboard settings, what are my shortcuts for Dark Orbit, my keybind settings. I will link it now so you can check it out. And that was the shortcuts. That must be it now. Wait, here we features, we went right. Let me check again. Yeah, that was all the features. Now browser settings. Rekey promoted. No, we don't know. We just disable that. Show speed, dial suggestion. No, also not automatically. That can stay automatically. I think, wait. If we go at basics. No, okay, just go at browser. Maybe I just passed that one. Click on browser and just do what I just did. user interface. Yeah, I when I was going down, I forgot to do this few settings here. All right, that must be it from the settings. What I like to do is, if I finished all the stuff here, like when you did your RAM limiter and CPU limiter settings, then get rid of this window, which you press here on the, you make right click and press hide sidebar. I don't want this. And then you go into my description and copy the link. When you copied the link, which I will put here now, press on it. Yes, enable, allow it. And then you have to put this one on the highest. Basically, you are allowing Adobe Flash Player to use unlimited resources on your PC. And by doing that, it will run Dark Orbit much more smoother. Your FPS will stay much more stable at 60. And yeah, that's it with all the settings. And now we will head up into the game. So we just log it into Dark Orbit, and I will change my design to Dusklight Spectrum. And let's go into Dark Orbit in game. I am using a full damage config, and like my slow config is full damage, and my speed config is 8 drones with shield and 2 drones with laser. And if you are new to my channel, then it's important for you, every time when you log in into Dark Orbit, make right click, quality and low. If you do that, then your FPS will be even more stable. Okay, let's go full screen modus, and not modus, mode. And we will put everything on high. We will play with high settings. Zones high, background high, explosions high, engines high. And let's press F. And quality low, check again. I have a tips and tricks video which I will link now. There's like also I am explaining their things, for example how to make the right click quality low on 3D, which doesn't work on like it's not the same as you do it on 2D. That's why check this video out, I will link it now. And wait, let me shoot one strainer here. Okay, when I kill something, my FPS stays at 60. That is nice. If you did everything until now, then you should be really good to go. And like, especially when you have a beast PC, then it should work for you to have like, I mean, I will test it out now. And it's important to play just around, just not test it out for 10-15 minutes and log out and say the browser is bad. Like for me, I have 60 FPS now, and the thing is, you have to fill up your Adobe Flash Player storage. Like when you kill something, it will save this information, and next time it will run it much faster, much better. So also make sure to download that browser on your SSD. Like, don't install it on your, if you have a HDD and SSD, then, or M.2, then save it on your M.2, the one which is faster. Then I guarantee you, your FPS will be much more stable. Okay, we have here one guy. We going to kill him really quick. Okay, he makes insta. Then I make insta too, no problem. Okay, we will test the browser out now for, let's say, 1 week. I will also use it on my videos, so you guys can see the results at the end. By far, I have, wait, when I just stand still and shoot the Cubicon, I have around 60 FPS, that's normal. Like, it's normal when you move your ship that your FPS is going down. It's also the first time that I play with this browser, so it's completely normal that my FPS is spiking, that it's not as stable as the Maxton 5 browser. But we have to mention as well, this browser is 2 days old. It's as I heard, it's not It still has some bugs. I was looking at the forums, YouTube videos and such, and we can say that we can say in like 1 week or 1 month there will be a lot of bug fixes for this browser. That means that the browser will run even more smoother and your gameplay will be all the time at the most stable FPS possible. And for me it's like 60 FPS. I will shoot this Cubicon now with only standing still and just take a look at my FPS. I will not move and just shoot the Cubicon. Right now it's 60 FPS. I have a memory of almost 400 megabyte and my FPS 61, 60, 58. Can I kill it from here? No, I can't. Let's fly there. I'm flying and I still have 60 FPS. Okay. Explosions, like it's not dropping down to when something explodes. Usually your FPS is spiking, but it was below, it wasn't below 55. So it's all good. And let's change the map to 2-6 and shoot there some ships and Cubicons too. Okay guys, I just realized there is something popping up here on the middle side the entire time. Like if you click here on the top right full screen mode on, then there is one thing which will appear on the top mid. So how to fix that? I just pressed the button F11 and it's basically a full screen button. And since then I don't have this anymore. So if you are, just make sure to watch the entire video so you are not missing infos like that, which is really important. And yeah, if you like, if it helped you out, then make sure to like. If you want me to test more browsers, let me know in the comment section below. Leave a like and also subscribe to not miss content like that. I will just shoot all the Cubicons here really fast. And what I will basically do is I will test out this browser for 1 week. I will not remove, like I'm not deleting my flash storage either way. But every browser has his own storage. So we will, first of all, this browser has to learn, like it has to save all the maps. You have to jump on all the maps. I give you an example. Basically, when you are starting Dark Orbit on a brand new browser, you know, when you make Insta, your Insta will look, you will see it after 1 second. That means, and on your next Insta, you will see it immediately when you press it. That's because your flash player storage is completely at zero. And you have to, basically it has to learn it, like it's saving and on the next time you see it and it much, like it runs just overall much smoother, faster. And here you can see right now when I shoot the Cubi, my FPS compared to the beginning is much more stable right now. I'm at 400 megabyte and I still have around let's say 40 till 60 FPS. For me it's really good results. But we will see after, let's say after 1 week, I will compare this browser with the Maxon 5 browser, and after 1 month when there was a big update, I will do it again. Okay, all the Cubicons are down. I hope you guys enjoyed it and see you guys on my next video.